What makes a thing contingent? How to model a contingent? And why contingent stop? Malaria is a serious and sometimes fatal disease. Until the 20th century, we don't know much about how to deal with its outbreak. In 1895, Rolando Ross embarked on his quest to determine whether mosquitoes transmitted malaria parasites to humans. Eventually, in July 1987, he designed a test to prove the theory. He won the Nobel Prize because of his achievement. It is difficult to overstate the importance of Ross's finding. The award of Nobel Prize hardly does the justice to the subsequent impact of his conclusions. Ross then wanted to prove that keeping the number of mosquitoes under a certain number will be the way to control the malaria outbreak. He even performed an experiment on an Egypt city. By controlling the number of mosquitoes, there are only 100 infection cases that year, compared to the normal 2,000 cases per year. However, the conclusion of this experiment was criticized by a lot of people. They argued that there could be other facts that contribute to the decrease in infection cases, such as the weather change. It is hard to prove they are wrong, since Ross can't repeat his experiment. So, he used another method to prove his theory, which is a mathematical model. He developed a simple model, now known as the classical Ross model, which explained the relationship between the number of mosquitoes and the incidence of malaria in humans. Here is the paper he published in 1950. To find out whether one element affects malaria outbreak as expected, we simply need to change the initial value of that parameter and calculate the result of the simulation. The advantage of using the model to simulate the contagion is we can repeat it as many times as we like. Since then, over 100 years, mathematical models have been used to provide an explicit framework for understanding malaria transmission dynamics in the human population. Several years later, in 1927, Kerbach and McKendrick want to study why contagion stop. At that time, there are two mainstream opinions. One is that the decreasing number of susceptible individuals. The other one is the pathogen becomes less infection over the time. To find out the answer, they create a model in which they consider a fixed population with only three components. They are S, which is the number of susceptible individuals, I, which is the number of infected individuals, and R is the number of recovered individuals. This is the famous SIR model. If you want to find out the equations behind this model, I include a link in the description for you to read. Don't be overwhelmed by this formula. You don't have to master it to use the model. Just like when you have a new tool, it is not necessary to know how it works most of the time. Knowing how to use it is enough. I've run one simulation using Python. Here is the result. If you want to play with the model, I put the link to it in the description. Apply the model to get the conclusion that the decreasing number of susceptible individuals is the reason why the outbreak stops. The outbreak will stop before all susceptible individuals being infected. You may hear herd immunity a lot these days. That is where it comes from. Knowing why contagion stop is not enough. What we really want to know is how to make it stop. The good news is, nowadays we find two key elements of contagions, R number and super spreader. The R number is a way of rating the disease ability to spread. R is the number of people that one infected person will pass down a virus to, on average. For example, measles has an R number of 15 in population without immunity. That means, on average, one people will spread measles to 15 others. Since we can't capture the moment people are infected, instead, scientists work backward, using the available data to calculate the R number. which normally are D, the duration of time someone is infectious, O, the opportunity for transmission during this period, T, the transmission probability during each opportunity, S, the probability that the person on the other end of the interaction is susceptible to that infection, DOTS for short. If we multiply them together, we get the value of reproduction number. Now we know that R number is not a fixed number. Instead, it changes as our behavior changes or as immunity develops. A super spreader is someone who infects more than the R number. Super spreaders are highly infectious. Locate the super spreader is one crucial part to control the contagion. The idea of R number and super spreader explains why wearing a mask, social distance, and even lockdown can help us to fight COVID-19. Not only disease can be contagious, but also a lot of other things, such as popular book, movie, or music, economic crisis, hot topic. They all fall into the category of contagious. Knowing that gives us a fresh angle to look at the event. We can use the model to simulate them or apply the idea of R number and super spreaders to stimulate or cool down the trend. Three takeaways. 1. Mathematical model can be used to simulate contagions. 2. Key element of contagions, R number and super spreader. 3. Lots of events fall into the category of contagious, so we can apply the same model to them. I'm always here at your service. See you in the next one.